Here's my setup to mix Plaster of Paris. My Plaster of Paris came in this container. Sometimes they come in a box loose, but you still do the same preparation. Here's the powder in there. We had made a couple casts using this Plaster of Paris. I don't know where it went. Do you guys see the cast in there? So, if you have a mold, you can pour Plaster of Paris into it. So a mold would be like a silicone shape, and you can pour the Plaster of Paris into it, and then it will create this mold. And then I added details that I carved into it. You can also use Plaster of Paris to create a mold. I could carve this out of the plaster after we do this type of process, make this shape, and buy silicone mold that you create around it, and you put it in a little container, and then you can make thousands of whatever object you're wanting. Today we'll just be using a reductive method. In sculpture, there's two methods, a reductive method or an additive method. Reductive method, you take away from something to create the object. Additive method, you add to the object. Like piling on clay to form like a coil bowl, maybe. Or wire, putting wire all together to create a form. You need clean, cold water. I have that over here in these containers. A clean mixing container, a putty knife or a trowel. I guess I could grab a palette knife. Why not? Let's do it. So, the mixing instructions: add 2 parts Plaster of Paris to 1 part cold water. I'll start with the Plaster of Paris because I know I have a limited amount of that. I will try to do, I don't know how much I have in here, maybe 4 cups I have. Let's see, measure it out. It has a working time of 7 to 12 minutes before it starts hardening. All right, my video stopped at a certain point. So what I did is I had filled this container with 2 cups of plaster. Now I'm going to add 2 more cups of plaster. See, additive method, add it up. Currently we're doing an additive method, right? If we were to be making this into a cast, that would be an additive method. Yet ultimately we are doing a reductive method because we're going to fill this up with the Plaster of Paris as a form. The form will be a rectangle. That rectangle will dry hard, we'll peel this exterior off, and we will begin carving a shape. Reductive method. So technically, I guess we're using both, but ultimately it's called a reductive method if you're carving into an object. Ooh, exactly. Almost exactly 6 cups. 2 parts plaster, back to the directions. 2 parts plaster, 1 part cold water, 40 to 50 degrees. I'd say that mine's at 60 right now. So, we have 6 cups of Plaster of Paris. We need 3 cups of water. Your amounts may be different. If you have 4 cups of Plaster of Paris, you need 2 cups of water. So I need 1 more cup to be 3 cups. Now I know that this soup container can do 3 cups. I'm gonna start with this paint mixing thing you can get just for free at Home Depot. And if need be, I'll finish. Did I get all of it out of there? Just since we're gonna reuse this. The working time is 7 to 12 minutes. That means you can mix it for 7 to 12 minutes. Then you need to put it into whatever container you want it to be the form of. And then allow it to dry. Cure. Allow it to cure. This mixing method is really similar to concrete, except you wouldn't really add as much water, but that's a fun material to work with. You don't get to carve into it, but you could shape it onto things. This seems rather watery to me. Let's see where it's hiding. Here's some of it. Just like your pancakes, you want to get out all the dry spots. I think I have it well mixed, just because when I'm bringing up this mixer stick, there's no dry spots left. So let's pour it into the container. Ooh, I saw some. Look at those thick spots. See, I missed some stuff. So I'll mix it some more in the container. There are about 4. It'll take 24 spots. Hours to cure. At least. Curing. Just put it in a spot that no one can knock it over. It'll be liquid for a really long time. So make sure no one can knock it over. I suggest keeping it open so that the air can also help the evaporation process. So after 1 hour. 1 hour. So correction. Take your mold out after 1 hour. A nice block. And then you can start to decide what your image will be. Mine is kind of be going to be, you have to do it on all six sides. I'm gonna attempt to take out the middle, but I don't know, I might wait on that. I'll probably use a drill too for that. Everything I'll be showing you, I'll be carving with a knife. Looks like I'm making a donut so far. I wanna make, there are these sea creatures. What are they called? They look like this, right? I know. Does look like that. And you're like, oh, so sea donut. Get one. Or a picture. What are these things called? They're hollow inside. And it's like, hollow there, all through. I forget what the pattern on it is, but I know it's delicate looking. Usually they're thin shells. Shells. Okay. So, each elevation, depending on your form, has different considerations. Mostly these are all just ellipses for me, but maybe you're making a pyramid. I don't know. I don't know what you want to make. Make something that you'd want to be in your room, like a about a place that you have been to or would like to go to. A symbolic element. Nothing too architectural. I suggest not trying the Eiffel Tower. That is a masterpiece. So maybe do a masterpiece of the natural world. I think that would be an attainable task. So I was thinking of sea urchin. Start carving with a knife. Try to carve away from yourself. Marked pretty much where these two need to meet, but with a slope in between. It's a soft butter knife, so. What's that?
Like, I think it's like of us.
Yeah, I want to try one of those.
Really? Mm-hmm. Really?
Yes, really.
See, I'm more doing like that one.
Yeah?
Really?
You want to try to do this? Do you want to try to do this?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, bring your chair up.
Hi, my name is Professor Bellamy the Second. Well, second because, like, my mom is money.
Okay, so I'll use this one. Knife. I'm handing it this to you. And keep hold your hand strong on it.
Then do the size?
Yeah, and only do it up to... Here, you should start this side. Wait. This side. I'm trying to get it there to there. Do you see how I carved away? So I'm trying to carve off all this stuff in between here.
Oh, okay.
Got it?
Like that?
Yeah, I like to hold it like this.
I'm gonna hold it like this.
But I want you to do this one. So we're far away. Do you see how I'm holding it?
Can you do my hand?
Sure. Put your thumb on here. And your hand across there, yeah. That's how I was doing it. It's still pretty soft, so. You don't need the sharpest part. See how I'm going, like,
I'm side trying, of it? I think I need
to. You feel like you're in an awkward spot here. Yeah. No, I swear that it's easier.
It's not easier for me.
You can't do it just at the top. Just do it, have your knife on the side.
I think
first.
Look at all that I got off. Oh my gosh. Look how much.
Woohoo.
Oh my gosh.
Can we do this one now?
Oh, this is good.
Here.
You will be hearing the Grinch. I should have said that before. But will they be hearing the Grinch?
Yeah, they might.
I'm sorry if it's, like, too loud. Ha ha. I'm sorry that noise was probably, like, a noise. See, I got it off, like, with this hand.
Hurrah!
I was going, this hand is much stronger than this hand.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's a good idea.
You can't watch your TV. And do this with a knife.
I just wanted to see that.
Okay, then take a pause and watch the show. Please don't do two things at once. I feel like
I don't like, wait, let's see. Is this the same as that? Let's see. Oh yeah, it's, sorry.
I'm gonna take these stuff off. We're watching The Grinch.
Yes, we are.
It's really cool. I think you should check it out.
Yeah, you recommend it?
Yeah, I recommend it. Has like really good drawing skills. It wasn't really drawing. And I like the Who's a lot.
Do you? Why?
When you get to the end, it's so heart.
So heart? So heartwarming?
It's, yeah.
Aww.
This is really your students have kids?
Some of them, yeah.
All the students there have kids, it's really entertaining for them. They love it.
All kids love it?
Yeah. Maybe all of them. They all don't have to like it, right?
Right.
So if your kid like doesn't like really it like in the first thing, it's okay, because and if your kid's like really heartwarming and it doesn't, she or he doesn't like the movie, like the part of it, but in the end, it's like so heartwarming.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna switch the opening. Wait, it's pretty much the same size. I'm gonna change the opening to... No, I'll keep it the same. Okay. So... for overnight, I put it in a Ziploc bag because I wanted to keep it softer so that I can cut away the larger stuff initially. Yeah, it stayed a little moist. Otherwise, it would have dried out more. So there's a couple things I wanted to share with you guys. So your curing time will be 1 hour, and then you take off the mold, which is the carton of milk or something that you can peel off that has a waxy interior. And then carve off the big stuff. As it dries, it'll be easier and easier to work on details. And you can, at the very end, you can even finish it with sandpaper. But overall, with coming up with your idea, you know, make it a form, something that has a shape. Think of just a basic shape. At this point, I'm just thinking cylinder. And then I will create sphere on the other edges. And I might be keeping these open areas more, these areas that will have openings, more flat,
because I have an overall idea, and I'll share it with you once you can get the view from above. I'm just charging my phone, so can't do both of them right at the moment. I hope it makes the camera wobble so much. It'd be good to have the camera on something else. Just keep redrawing and cut away. Like I have this area here that I've cut away how I want it to be, and then this side is more, has more of the curve. That's how deep I want it to be, but I need it to get the same curvature as this one. So I'll cut away there. Come here. Come here, Berkey. Come on. Say hi. Say hi. This is Burke. He is a boxer. He's Bellamy's best friend. He's my fur baby. Very lovely.
What?
I was introducing Burke.
Oh, hi.
You look there. Right?
Yeah. I'm calling my friend, that's why there's lots of me. Just telling you. Not Sean.
I don't.
Scraping this, mom, no, your teacher. And I'll be coming.
And if you need to, you can
I'll be
mask.
Coming soon.
Oh.
Marie?
It's not dry yet, but a mask might be helpful later. Thank you.
doing soon. Your family's doing soon. Every Thursday. You don't have to do it. Just trying to get the little boogers in there. No, I don't want to do that yet. We can do that. You can use a sponge against sponge. Or you can wait till it dries more on your sandpaper.
Start softening it up. I'm going to lose some things that I like about it.
I can clean it. I'll clean the things.
You don't like doing it?
Yeah, I don't want to do it.
You want to do it like this? The
yeah.
Outer edge?
No.
No? Okay.
I'll clean it.
If Not as fun as it looks, huh?
Yeah, I want to with the pencil number.
Oh, yeah, we're done with that big, the big moves. We're getting now to details.
Let me wipe. I'll wipe all of them for you. Tell me if you need wipe. And wipe. Switch.
Oh, thank you. Oof. I like this.
So you don't have to stop. Bellamy again.
Thank you, dear.
Wipe. And if this gets like dirty, like it won't be like this dirty, but it'll be like dirty like this. That's fine. Just get a wet wipe or whatever wet thing you have to take it off. I'm gonna be back with another one.
Thank you.
Thank you.
yet off the shelves at Home Depot or Rona. Up, but here it's over the paint and you're not pulling. So I'm actually going to kind of leave it alone. It was good. And it's where it's a little stuff. It's been there. And it's always test it with your fingers. If you're sticking to it too soon.
Yeah.
sand this, but I'm going to suffer along with the do-it-yourself crowd and just use a sanding sponge, because if you're just trying to patch one little hole in the wall, this is what I recommend. Don't go buying a big hole sander. One handy little tip is you can use your pan, push it up against the wall, and just sand really gently, and a lot of that dust is all just going to fall into the pan. Also, I highly recommend wearing a mask, so when I'm done talking, I'm going to go do that. Basically, just try and sand gently and relatively flat, right, so you're not pushing too hard on any of your lines, just with a nice flat.
Too hard.
This is just water.
Inside corner ceiling joint. So I'm going to start by 3-inch putty knife, and I box the hole in. texture here.
I did my mom's makeup.
And she did her makeup too.
But by myself. And this is the finishing touch.
Here's the final piece. Bellamy's gonna explain the last part I did at the end of the video.
Huh? Hi.
So you can use water.
We used water. We can use water. We could use water.
And a paintbrush.
And a paintbrush.
Not on that. Just put the water on it.
You put the water on it.
And then you can smooth things out.
Yeah, I'm going to show you first. You smooth it? I'm going to show you guys some front. Not gonna be really straight.
You don't want to get it too wet.
Yeah. Though.
So that's probably enough.
Yeah. Because we already did.
All right. You don't have to do something as textured as this, but I was just had my heart set on it. I have plans for it. And good luck. Have fun.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope you go and teach this to somebody else. That's my goal.
Or one of your family members.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Bye.